Hi everyone and welcome to A1 level of German language course, and today is the 19th lesson of A1 level of German language course, in which we are going to talk about the adjective ending in accusative case. Adjective describes some property or characteristic of any noun. This property can be new, old, big, small, beautiful, etc. And because we know that in German language there is a gender of each noun, and based on the gender of noun we have to take a lot of things into consideration, and adjective is one of these things where we have to check in which case we are currently talking about and what is the gender of the noun. And currently we know that we are talking about the accusative case. Therefore, one thing is fixed, but the second thing is the gender of noun, and we will see that how the adjective ending will change depending on different genders of noun. We will see it for masculine, feminine and neuter noun, as well as plural. And because we know that there are two different types of articles in German language, one is the definite article and other is the indefinite article, so we will see both in both cases what will be the situation or what will be the adjective ending when we are using a definite article and indefinite article. So let's start with the definite article first. I have taken one example of bus. Bus in German language is masculine noun and it has article der, and in accusative its article is den. But if we want to use an adjective for this bus or bus, then we have to add an an at the end of the adjective. So if we have an adjective neue, we have to add an an at the end. Neue means new. And if the some action is being performed on a bus, then for whatever adjective we use, we have to add an an at the end of adjective. And this will be valid for all the masculine nouns. Next, we have our feminine case where we are using the noun Katze. Katze means cat, which is a feminine noun. And if I use any adjective before cat or Katze, we will have to add an A at the end of the adjective. So if the adjective is klein, for example, which means small, we have to add an A at the end of it when we are going to use this adjective in accusative case for a feminine noun. Next, we have a neuter example where I have taken the noun Kind, which means kid or a child, and I have taken the adjective as nett, which means nice. So when I use this adjective or any other adjective before a neuter noun, I will use an A at the end of this adjective. So it will be das nette Kind, the nice kid. Then I have the plural case in which I have to add an an at the end of adjective. I have taken the same adjective net, but because the noun is plural, which is Kinder. Kinder means kid, which is singular is kid and plural is Kinder. And I have, in this case, in plural case, I have to add an an at the end of adjective, whatever the adjective will be for whatever plural case in accusative case. Next, I have indefinite articles. I have taken the same noun, bus, to keep the things simple. But in case of indefinite article, I will use einen neuen Bus. So neuen will remain neuen, which means that every adjective will get an an at the end, whether we use the definite article or indefinite article. Next is Katze, eine kleine Katze. Without adjective, it's eine Katze, but if we add an adjective, it will become eine kleine Katze, a small cat. So here we have added A at the end of the adjective. And next we have a neuter noun. I have again kept the same noun king, but here you see that this is, if we remove this adjective here, then it's ein Kind, but if we add an adjective, it will get an as at the end and it will become nettes, a nice kid. So here this n and this n, here this a and this a or this a, similarly here this s and s. So here through this you can just memorize that how this ending of adjective can be, because it is correspond to the last alphabet of the definite article in accusative case. Then I have some examples. Ich brauche einen neuen Staubsauger. I need a new vacuum cleaner. Now here, this brauchen is a verb which means to need or to require. If we conjugate it with respect to ich, it will become brauche. Next important thing to know is the gender of this noun. This noun is a masculine noun, Staubsauger. So, and if we are going to use an indefinite article, we will be lying somewhere here. We have to refer this section of the sentence, and this section of the sentence says that for masculine noun you have to use einen neuen. So this adjective will receive an additional an at the end for a masculine noun in accusative case. Next example is er trägt eine moderne Brille. He wears a modern glasses. Now here you see that the verb is tragen, which means to wear or to carry. If we conjugate it with respect to er, it will become er trägt. Next important thing to know is what is the gender of this noun. Brille means glasses and it is a feminine noun. Therefore, we will refer to this section of sentence, section of the table. This section of table says that we have to add an A at the end of adjective if the noun is feminine in case of accusative case. So we have added an A here. Next example is sie kauft ein rotes Auto. She buys a red car. Now, kaufen is a verb which means to buy. And next thing is to determine what is the gender of this noun, because this gender of noun will determine the adjective ending, and the gender of noun is neuter. So we will refer to this section of the table, which says that we have to add an as at the end of the adjective. This we have done. So let me write all the adjective also here. So neue we have used, modern, we have used rot, which means red. Colors can also be used as adjectives. Next is sie trinken den heißen Tee. Now in this, the first section was for indefinite articles, and now we will see how it is going to change in the definite articles. Sie trinken den heißen Tee. Now trinken is a German verb which means to drink, and if it remains trinken, then we know that this Z means they drink the hot tea. Tee in German language is a masculine noun, therefore it has an article den in case of accusative case, and heiß is an adjective which means hot, but because it is being used in accusative case, therefore we will add an an at the end and we will follow this section of the table. Next is er hasst die blaue Hose. He hates the blue pant. Now hassen is a German verb which means to hate, and if we conjugate hassen with respect to er or he, then it will become hasst. And next we need to know the gender of the Hose. Hose is a feminine noun, it has article die, and we know that if the feminine, for feminine noun in accusative case, we have to add an a at the end of adjective. So we have added an a at the end of adjective. The adjective here is blau or blue. So we are using color as an adjective in this case also. Next is wir lesen das interessante Buch. We read the interesting book. Lesen is a German verb which means to read. For wir will it will remain lesen. Next we need to know what is the gender of Buch. Buch is a neuter noun, therefore it has an article das, and since we are using definite article, so we will refer to this section of the table, and we this section of table says that we have to add an a at the end of adjective. Here the adjective is interessant, which means interesting. Now the last example is for plural. Sie verkaufen die frischen Gemüse. Now again, verkaufen is a verb which means to sell. So kaufen and verkaufen are the opposite of each other. Kaufen means to buy and verkaufen means to sell. Sie verkaufen, they sell die frischen Gemüse. Gemüse means vegetables, and frisch is a adjective which means fresh. But since Gemüse is a plural noun and we are using this in accusative case, why is it in accusative case? Because Gemüse is something on which we are performing an action. We are selling the vegetables. Therefore, it is in the accusative case, and we will follow the rule which is for plural, because vegetables is plural, and we know that in this case we have to add an an at the end of adjective. So we have added an an here. So this is all about adjective ending when we use definite or indefinite article. But in the next lessons we will see that how we have to deal with the adjective endings when we use possessive pronouns, or we use personal pronouns, or we do not use any article, for example. So there are more lessons to come related to accusative before we conclude the accusative case. I hope you like it, and please support me through like and comment on this video, so that it can reach to maximum people and a lot of people can benefit from this. Thank you again. Bye.